exponential function y is equal to 50 times 2 raised to the x, select the statement that is correct. The first statement says that the initial amount is 2. Well, to find the initial amount, we need to substitute 0 for x and then evaluate. When we substitute 0 for x, we get 2 to the 0 is 1, and 1 times 50 is 50. That tells us that the initial amount is 50. The initial amount is not 2, so A is not the correct answer. Part B says the growth rate is 200%. Well, to find the growth rate, what we need to do is to find the percentage increase as x goes up by 1 unit. So let's go ahead and fill in our table with x equals 0, x equals 1, and x is equal to 2, and investigate the percentage increase. When we substitute 1 for x, we get 2 to the first is 2, 2 times 50 is 100. When we substitute 2 for x, we get 2 squared is 4, and 4 times 50 is 200. To find the percentage increase from x equals 0 to 1, we first of all find the increase from 50 to 100. 100 minus 50 is 50. We then divide that by the starting amount, which is 50. And we get 50 over 50, which is 1, where if we write that as a percentage, that's 100%. So from x equals 0 to x equals 1, the amount increased by 100%. But what about from x equals 1 to x equals 2? There, the amount increased from 100 to 200. That's a 100 increase. We then divide by the starting amount, which is 100. And again, we get 1, which is 100%. So that tells us that the growth rate is not 200%, the growth rate is 100%. Our next statement says that the vertical intercept is 0, 2. But we can already see from our table that the vertical intercept is 0, 50. So C is not the correct answer. Our next statement says that the growth factor is 2. The growth factor is the number that we need to multiply in order to go from one quantity to the next for each unit increase in x. So 50 times what number is 100? Well, 50 times 2 is 100. 100 divided by 50 is 2. We also see that 100 times 2 is equal to 200. 200 over 100 is equal to 2. Therefore, the growth factor is 2. D is the correct answer. The last statement says that the decay rate is 10%. But we can see that our values are not decaying, the values are growing. So E